Hello, and welcome to Food U. I'm Gabe.
I'm Christina.
And we're back. I know it's been a while since we've been on the air. Hope you had a great summer, and today we're going to jump right into fall with some great fall dishes.
Yes, we've got some festive Halloween-themed food for you today. We're going to be making spiderweb tomato soup. I know, right? And we're going to make the Ghost of Monte Cristo sandwiches. And we're going to make some Cinna-Mummy cookies, which I have dubbed Cinna-Mummies. And those will be fun, a great thing to make with the kids for Halloween.
It sounds spooky and delicious.
Yes. So, first up, we're going to start our tomato soup. So, all you need to make this soup is a few pantry ingredients in about 15 minutes. So the first thing we're going to do is chop up an onion, and we're going to use one medium onion in 2 tablespoons of butter in the pan. And Gabe, while I'm peeling this onion real quick, would you mind popping 2 tablespoons of the butter in that pan?
Okay.
And we're gonna melt the butter over medium low heat.
What's the spider web in the soup?
It's gonna be sour cream. And I'll show you how to put that in your soup and make it in the shape of a spider web on top.
Okay.
I know a lot of people like sour cream in their tomato soup or in their chili. So once again, we've got 2 tablespoons of butter melting over medium-low heat, and we've got 1 medium onion that we're just kind of rough chopping. The pieces don't have to be the same size, but it's helpful if they're about the same size so they cook evenly. But in the end, all of this is gonna get blended together and you won't be able to tell.
It seems like fall goes by really quickly nowadays. There's so much stuff going on. It seems like Labor Day happens and then it's New Year's.
I know.
So we really want to enjoy these foods and have fun with them and be fun recipes for the cheering too.
It will. And if you remember last year, I think we made beanie weenies.
Yeah.
For Thanksgiving.
We made beanie weenies. I basically poured ingredients from various cans into this pot. But it was very good.
It is. So if you're interested in something else, you can still check that episode out on our YouTube channel.
Okay, I'm about good right there.
Got butter melted. There we go. And I'm going to drop onions on the counter. I'm going to drop these onions right into the pan. And if it sizzles just a little bit, your pan's about right.
I'll hear it.
When you use a heavier pan like this, it usually takes just a little bit longer to get it heated than it does a regular pan.
But it holds the heat and distributes it more evenly and longer, too.
It does, and that's why these are some of my favorite pans to cook with. All right, so there we go. 1 medium onion chopped up. And we're going to keep this in the butter, medium-low heat, for about 3 or 4 minutes until it's translucent.
What does that mean?
It means, like, slightly clear. So you can tell it's cooked. When you chop an onion, it's got that opaque white or yellow color to it, and it'll start to clear up. So those are almost translucent, and we want to catch them right now just before they turn brown on the actual onion. So after these have cooked 4 or 5 minutes, we are going to add 1.5 cups of chicken stock or chicken broth, either one. If you don't have this on hand, you can use just water. But I like to use the chicken broth because it adds a little more flavor.
Could you use vegetable broth?
Yeah, you could. I wouldn't advise using beef broth. I would use vegetable or chicken. And another one of my pantry staples and favorites is chicken base. I don't know if you've ever seen that. It comes in a little canister that you can buy next to the chicken broth in the grocery store. And you just mix like 1 tablespoon with 1 cup of water and you get 1 cup of chicken broth. And you can keep it on hand in the fridge and it makes it pretty easy.
Okay, what are we doing here?
All right, so we've got the chicken stock in with the onions. It's coming up to a boil. And to that, we are going to add 2 cans of whole peeled tomatoes.
Be careful because it's gonna splatter.
I will, can I borrow that? So you can find these in the grocery store as well. You don't have to drain them. We're gonna add them with their juice to the pot. And you can see each of these cans has about 10 tomatoes, so that saves a lot of work. There we go. And again, that's 2 of these 14.5-ounce cans. There we go. And will you season this up with some salt and pepper, please? And at this point, you could add a little garlic powder or a little curry powder if you wanted to change up the flavoring. But we're just gonna do a little salt and pepper today. All right, I think that's good.
Mm, that's a lot of soup. And it's coming out a little. So I gotta give it a little more. Okay.
All right. And a little black pepper. I think that's good. All right, stir that up. We're gonna turn it down to low and we're gonna let this simmer for 10 minutes. And we're gonna take a quick break. When we come back, we'll see how our soup's simmering.
What is Wingate? A thriving university nestled in a quiet community near Charlotte. Named sixth best value in the South by US News & World Report. Leading the way in the health sciences with pharmacy, PA studies, and nursing. What is Wingate? Big enough to offer 22 NCAA sports, small enough to attract the best and brightest in the world. What is Wingate? Wingate is you. Wingate University, major in a great life.
Welcome back to Food U. As always, we want to thank the Union County Agricultural Center and Ms. Sally McNeil for allowing us to use this set and the wonderful kitchen here. Also, if you want to revisit this episode, you can find us on the Wingate University channel on YouTube, and you can find Food U on Facebook as well.
Yep, so we are back in our soup simmering away. And it's got probably, I don't know, 8 or 9 more minutes left on that. So we're going to let this chill out. And next on our agenda is the Ghost of Monte Cristo sandwiches.
So count or ghost?
I'm calling it the ghost.
Okay.
But they're called Monte Cristo sandwiches. And they originated in the U.S. in the early 1900s. But it's pretty much like a fried ham and cheese sandwich. And it's modeled after the French croque monsieur, if you've ever had that.
I probably have. I don't remember.
So what you need for this super easy sandwich is potato bread, Swiss cheese, ham, turkey, and some eggs and milk.
Okay, so I'm gonna start assembling a sandwich, and you're gonna start making the egg mixture.
I am.
And I'm going to put some butter in the pan for when we fry these things.
Sounds good. So we're going to do 1 tablespoon of butter and 1 tablespoon of olive oil in the pan over medium heat. And for our egg mixture here, we will use 3 whole eggs and 1/4 cup of milk and a little bit of salt and pepper. There we go. Now when you're assembling your sandwiches, like Gabe's doing, you want to do 1 piece of cheese, 1 piece of ham, 1 piece of turkey, and then another piece of cheese so that your meat's mixed in between the cheeses when it melts.
Mm. Meat and cheese fried. Delicious. God bless America.
A little warm.
Well, you said medium. Back that down a little bit. I'd like to give a shout out to my little cousin Tori, who watches Food U. Also, Marcus Kirkland. I see you. And all of our fans. Thank you for watching.
All right, so I've got my egg mixture ready to go. Before we dip that,
excuse me, Christina.
Yes.
I'm going to turn the heat down on this soup. What do you think?
That sounds fine.
Okay.
It's bubbling away, so we're going to knock it down just a little bit. So the reason that I call these the Ghost of Monte Cristo is we have these cute little ghost cookie cutters. And so we're going to cut out our little sandwiches and make them in a ghost shape for Halloween.
Now?
Yeah. And I also brought a pumpkin too.
Do you think the cookie cutter is going to make it all the way through?
Yes. Looks good.
I'm just making sure it goes all the way through. There, I eat at a local sandwich shop. You may have heard of it. They have like foot-long sandwiches. And sometimes they don't cut all the way through your foot-long sandwich, and it's frustrating when you go to eat the sandwich and you have to, and it like everything pulls apart and falls out. But so I just want to make sure that it goes all the way through like that. Okay?
All right, good job. I'm going to pour this egg into a shallow dish, or in this case, I'm just using a regular plate. And this will make it easy to dip our sandwich into. You can see the layers there. And we're gonna put the sandwich in the egg mixture, let it sit there for just a second, absorb all the goodness, and then flip it over and do the same thing.
This is a little messy, but I'm sure it's gonna be worth it.
It will be.
This is fun for the youngins too.
It is, messy fun.
Here I go, into the hot frying pan.
Yep, be careful.
Yeah. Excuse me, I'm going to rinse my hands off.
It's fine.
And I'm going to get a spatula.
While he's doing that, I'm going to assemble the other one. So remember, one slice of Swiss cheese. And if you don't like Swiss cheese, you could use a different kind. And one slice of ham, or that's turkey. And one slice of turkey, or ham. I've got it all kinds of backwards.
It doesn't matter. Yeah, it's all meat.
And then another slice of cheese. And I like to use the thin slice so that it's not a crazy amount of cheese in it. Mm-hmm. And then we'll use our cookie cutter again.
That's a different one. Nope, that's the same one.
There we go. And you can get these in different shapes and sizes, and you don't have to cut them, but I think it's fun. And again, we'll dip that in the egg mixture.
How long should I be? Oh, I'm going to flip that.
Until it's golden brown. So depending on your heat, it can take 2 or 3 minutes.
That looks good.
Yeah, it looks just like French toast. And then this one is nice.
Why can't it be American toast?
Because it originated in France.
Mm. This would be a good, the meal that we're making would be good to serve on Halloween night. As you're handing out candy at your door for trick-or-treaters.
Absolutely, very festive.
If your trick-or-treaters are smoking a cigarette at the door, they're probably too old.
This is true.
I've had that happen.
I'm gonna grab a plate.
Or vaping, if they're vaping, they're also probably too old. All right, I'm gonna get this.
That is so perfect.
I'm gonna get this Cristo onto this plate here.
All right, one ghost done.
Oh yeah, flip it. You're right. That looks like French toast and/or a pancake.
Mm-hmm. In fact, I think it was in restaurants in the early 1900s. It was called a French toast sandwich a lot. So there you go. Same method, just with meat and cheese in it. So we're going to let this finish frying. We're going to check on our soup. We're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we'll dust these little guys with powdered sugar. And we'll finish our soup off. And we'll get going with our next item.
See you in a little bit.
Planning your next step in life? Come complete your education in a dynamic, caring environment at Wingate University. Enrollment and construction have skyrocketed in the past 2 decades as students pursue challenging and rewarding degrees in fields like the health sciences, business, and education. U.S. News and World Report has named Wingate University the 6th best value in the South. Visit one of our 3 great campuses, Wingate, North Carolina, Hendersonville, or Charlotte, or check us out at wingate.edu. Major in a great life at Wingate University.
Welcome back. We've got our sandwiches all plated up. Okay. Gabe's got a new power tool. And we're ready to blend up our soup. So this has simmered for at least 10 minutes. The tomatoes have kind of popped open a little bit, and you can help them by squishing them a little bit. Just be careful because the juice will shoot out. And what do you have there in your hand?
A stick blender.
It's awesome. Okay. It's a nice tool when you're making pureed soups. You can put the blender straight into the liquid, and as long as you keep that head submerged, then it blends everything for you. And you don't have to wait for it to cool. Put it in a regular blender, pour it back in the pot. Saves you a lot of steps. So.
Okay, so we're gonna blend up the soup now.
Alrighty. And you wanna keep your blender moving just like Gabe's doing so that you get all of it blended and incorporated.
What I'm doing is hitting each tomato first, get them kind of broken up.
It's a good idea.
Thank you.
Not very hard, it just takes a little patience. And so all those onion pieces that we cooked earlier are now getting pulverized together, so you have all the flavor without eating a piece of onion or tomato. And we're almost there. Looking pretty good?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good. All right, so soup's done. And what we're gonna do is ladle a little bit of it into bowls. There we go. And again, this is a great idea for, yeah, Halloween night or for a kid's party. If your kids like tomato soup. I don't think I liked it when I was a kid. That was more an acquired taste as a grown-up.
Speaking of kids, Christina and I went to the skating rink recently. And it was a bunch of kids and us.
True story.
And we had a great time, and we danced and requested 90s rap music. And I wore my gold chain because I know Christina likes that a lot. And we had a great time together.
Okay. So we've got our soup in the bowl, and I've got sour cream here. You may be wondering what on earth I'm doing putting sour cream in a Ziploc bag, because that's pretty weird and messy. But we're gonna make our spider web. So you wanna put like a couple tablespoons of sour cream in a Ziploc bag and just cut a very tiny hole on the end, the corner. There we go. And what you're gonna do, it's gonna be like a piping bag, like making cupcakes. And we're gonna make a couple circles. So one, two, three. And then I'll come over here and do the same thing. One, two, three. And they don't have to be perfect, trust me. And then we're gonna take a couple toothpicks. I like to use two because it makes it a little bit wider. And you're gonna start in the middle, and you're just gonna draw it out. You're gonna go the other side, push it out. And you're gonna do this all the way around to make a little spider web. And you wanna start in the middle every time to bring
Spooky.
It out. Right? And that is our spider web tomato soup.
This just occurred to me. You could also make this if you have a young child who does not eat his or her vegetables. Make him the soup and say, this is Spider-Man soup.
That's a great idea. So. There you go. You're welcome. So that's our soup. And to finish off our Monte Cristo sandwiches, we're going to put a little powdered sugar on the top, which is traditional for the sandwiches. And you can use a sifter, or if you don't have a sifter, one of my favorite tricks is to just use a slotted spoon out of the kitchen drawer.
You could also put a little like raspberry drizzle on these. That might just set it off.
That'd be really good.
And add a little color too.
That would be very, very good. All right, so we have our soup. Move one of these little guys over here. There we go. And we've got this going. And we're going to take another quick break. And when we come back, we're going to teach you how to make these super cute Cinna-Mummies.
Cinna-Mummies. See you soon.
Your extraordinary future begins at Wingate University with more than 35 undergraduate majors and graduate and professional programs in the health sciences, business, and education. Wingate University's enrollment has mushroomed and construction has skyrocketed in the past 2 decades. And Wingate is the 6th best value in the South, according to U.S. News and World Report. Most importantly, Wingate graduates get jobs. They're working all over the Carolinas and the U.S. Major in a great life at Wingate University.
Welcome back to Food U. Remember, if you want to watch this episode later, and I know you will, go to the Wingate University YouTube channel and find our episodes there, Food U, and Food U on Facebook.
Yes. So we've got everything cleaned up from our soup, kind of, and we're ready to do our Cinna-Mummy cookies. And these are cookies. They're super easy. All you need is a refrigerated pie crust, and you can make your own, but you know, in efforts to be super simple, we're just using a refrigerated one. You let it sit out of the fridge for like 5 or 10 minutes so that you can unroll it easily. And you just need a circle cookie cutter. And we're gonna cut maybe 10 of these guys. And when I cut them, would you mind putting them on the cookie sheet for me? And because it's pie crust, it's not really gonna expand that much. And so, it's okay if they're not, you know, like 4 inches apart. They're not gonna spread like a cookie would. And we're just gonna do 10 of these guys.
Okay.
All right, so with our leftover crust, we're gonna take a sharp knife and we're gonna cut strips. And these cookies are going to look like little mummy faces.
Spooky.
I know. I tell you what, while I'm cutting these little strips, we've got 3 tablespoons of melted butter here. And what we're gonna do is take a pastry brush and brush them generously with butter all over the tops.
Is it okay if it gets off onto the paper too?
It is. And if you'll notice our cookie sheet is lined with parchment paper. And I know I've talked about parchment paper before, but I love it. And it makes cleanup super easy. It doesn't get the butter and the sugar and different things on your pan. And it helps promote even cooking.
And back in Bible times, didn't they write on parchment?
You know, I think so. I don't know if it was made by Reynolds, though.
Probably not. It's probably made by Moses.
And these strips of pie dough, that's our oven. These strips of pie dough don't have to be perfectly even, you know, thin or thick. You just cut them into strips. And I probably should have mentioned before that we have our oven just finished preheating, but you want to preheat it to 400 degrees Fahrenheit.
I've got some buttered up dough over here.
Awesome. So next step with the buttered up dough is to generously sprinkle some cinnamon sugar on top.
What do you mean cinnamon sugar?
So cinnamon sugar is a ratio of cinnamon and white sugar, like granulated sugar. And my
is that
favorite.
Too generous?
No, that's good. My favorite ratio, maybe a little less on the paper.
I didn't mean to do that.
That's okay. My favorite ratio is 1 to 3. So for instance, 1 tablespoon of cinnamon to 3 tablespoons of white sugar. And that'll give you about 1/4 cup of cinnamon sugar, which would be good for this recipe. And whatever you have left over, you can put on buttered toast. Mm. That was one of my favorite things my dad made me when I was little for breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
And the best part was like the really buttery, gooey pieces when you'd hit that.
Yes, and where the sugar got hard and it's like a little sugar butter piece.
Oh my gosh, it's so good.
My daddy made that for me too, and my grandma. Oh, I got stories about Grandma, but.
I remember crawling up on my dad's lap when he would be eating a piece of that and like asking if I could have a bite, but then getting the really gooey bite. And then he'd be like, why did you do that? Yes. All right, I've got some strips going. So what we want to do, I found these cute little candy eyes at the craft store. And I think you can find them at some grocery stores right now with it being Halloween. And they're just little pieces of white candy with a black dot on them, so they look like eyeballs. And we're just gonna put a couple on here. And you can put them real close together, like they're peeking, or you can put them far apart. You can just make crazy looking eyes. I don't know, I like have fun with it. You can make them look in different directions.
How do you do that?
Find one that's closer to the bottom. Mm-hmm. And match it with one that's closer to the top and have them look in different ways. And while Gabe's putting these eyes on, I'll show you. Go ahead and take your strips and you're gonna lay it over the eyes. It's okay if it breaks because it's mummy tape.
It's a mummy and he's been buried for a long time.
Yes, and you're just gonna kinda, no real method to it, lay these strips over it. And then after I get mine on there, I like to take my cutter again and go right over it so that it's all in a circle and pinch off the extras. And that way he's perfectly covered when we're done. I'm gonna keep cutting strips here.
These mummies look crazy.
They do. But how fun would this be to do at like a kid's party or at a Halloween party?
A lot.
Classroom party. All kinds of fun. I'll tell you what, we're gonna keep making our mummies here. We're gonna take a real short break and we're gonna pop these guys in the oven. And when we come back, we'll show you the finished product and we'll say goodbye.
What is Wingate? A thriving university nestled in a quiet community near Charlotte. Named sixth best value in the South by U.S. News & World Report. Leading the way in the health sciences with pharmacy, PA studies, and nursing. What is Wingate? Big enough to offer 22 NCAA sports. Small enough to attract the best and brightest in the world. What is Wingate? Wingate is you. Wingate University. Major in a great life.
All right, we're back. Our Cinna-Mummies have spent 10 minutes in their 400 degree oven and they are out. Ooh. They're super cute. You can see their little faces. Ooh. I just think these are fun. So they're all ready to go. I'm gonna put them on our plates with our Monte Cristo and our spider web tomato soup. Mm-hmm. And all these recipes can be found on our Facebook page under Food U.
And we wanna thank the Union County Agricultural Center again and Sally McNeil for allowing us to use this fantastic facility. Hope you have a great fall season. Be safe out there. We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.